Hi, good afternoon, everybody. Welcome to Lord's Day Sunday Afternoon Devo. Episode 593, Part 2, your daily bread passage for Sunday, January the 9th, 2022. Here's your... Hang on just a second. Sorry about that. I had to tell somebody something. Sorry about that. But today is episode 593, part 2. And today we're going to be washed. That's all it says. W-A-S-H-E-D. Washed. And this is from Dave Brennan, derived from Titus 3, 3-7. So if you're excited about this, we'll smash that like button. Comment, how are you washed? Are you washed in the blood of the Lamb? Are you washed? that's more plainly. Are you washed? Mainly washed in the blood of the Lamb. Are you washed in the blood, in the soul cleansing blood of the Lamb? Are your garments spotless? Are they white as snow? Are you washed in the blood of the Lamb? But Dave writes, my friend Bill described Gerard, G-E-R-A-R-D, I know a Gerard, an acquaintance of his being very far from God for a very long time. But one day after Bill met with Gerard and explained to him how God's love had provided the way for us to be saved, Gerard became a believer in Jesus. Through tears, he repented of his sin and gave his life to Christ. Afterward, Bill asked Gerard how he felt. Wiping away tears, he simply answered, washed. He answered simply, washed. He got washed in the blood of the Lamb. I know a Gerard. I went to World Life with him. We called him G-Money. And this black boy, he's originally from Haiti. But we called him G-Money. And this guy was a small dude. So, Gerard, I hope you watch this. I'll be sure to leave him a message when I post it. I'll make sure to tag him in the post and make him to show it. But Gerard, hope you're doing good, buddy. Hope you're doing good. I hope you see this message. So, but I'll have to tell him to watch between 3 and 4 minutes for a short message for him, and maybe he'll watch it. So, if I don't forget. But last one I did with the when I do passages from the book of Titus, and I tried to make a message to my friend from World Life. His last name is Titus, but everybody just went around calling him Titus. I put a message in there, and I tried to tag him in it. It did not want to come. Did not want to tag him in the post. So somehow or another, it's clear. He's cleared his Facebook. I don't know, but I don't know how to get a hold of him. But Gerard, if you know how to get a hold of Titus, let him know that I've been sending him messages, but it won't come up on Facebook. It's not wanting to post. It won't not want to tag him. So. So what an amazing response. That's precisely... Let me pull my book open a little bit. I'm having a hard time seeing the edge of the page. That's precisely the essence of salvation made possible through faith in Jesus' sacrifice for us on the cross. So in 1 Corinthians 6, after Paul gives examples of how disobedience against God leads to separation from him, he says, this is what some of you were. But you were washed, you were sanctified, You were justified in the name of the Lord Jesus Christ. Verse 11 of 1 Corinthians 6. Washed, sanctified, justified. Words that point the believers to being forgiven and made right with Him. So Titus 3, 4 and 5 says, tells us more about this miraculous thing called salvation. God our Savior saved us, not because of righteous things we have done, but because of His mercy. He saved us through the washing of rebirth. Our sins keep us from God, but through faith in Jesus, sin's penalty is washed away. We become new creations, 2 Corinthians 5:17. Gain access to the Heavenly Father, Ephesians 2:18. And are made clean, 1 John 1:7. So He alone provides what we need to be washed. Amen. So are you washed in the blood? So why is it vital for you to be washed and sanctified by Jesus? What has it meant, or what will it mean for you to put your faith in Him? That's a good one there. Ponder those questions or leave a hypothetical answer. Dear Jesus, I know I've sinned against You, and I realize that the penalty for my sin is separation from You. Thank You for the salvation You've made possible and for drawing me close to You forever. Your Bible reading for this one is Genesis 23 and 24 and Matthew chapter 7. Coming up tomorrow in your Fantastic Monday, part 2 of episode 594, the passage is titled, Etch a Sketch Forgiveness. That's what it says, Etch a Sketch Forgiveness. And it is from a new person, another new person, Katara Patton, K-A-T-A-R-A, Katara Patton. P-A-T-T-O-N. And it is derived from Psalm 103, 7 through 13. So, stay tuned for that. I'll get to that sometime later this afternoon, later today. I'll try to get to that one. But that sounds like that's going to be a good one. A new person, a new name. So, coming up in your Turning Point video for this, your weekend Turning Point video today, it is, Are You Ready for a New Year? Number 2. And this week's title is New Year's Revolution. This is the second R of a new year, Revolution. And we're starting off with 1 Thessalonians 4:1 from the NIV, which we'll read in the recommended reading, my version, 1 Thessalonians 4, 1-10. So we'll sit there and compare the verses of the NIV verse and my verse. There is a footnote in the first section, and the same person from that one, James Clear, C-L-E-A-R, has the Turning Point. And the same person from the Turning Point is the one from the footnote in the first paragraph. So stay tuned to that. I'll get that in just a few minutes. And your weekend reading is Genesis 26 through 31. I hope you've read 26, 27, and 28 yesterday on Saturday, and then read 29, 30, and 31 today. Sometime today to read it. Or sometime by tonight to have the other three read. But if you haven't, go ahead and read the whole 6 chapters. It won't take you long. If you're into doing the Bible reading, but if you're not, then that's a little bit all right. I'm not too judgmental. You read the Bible when you read the Bible, so don't be forced to read it. When watching my videos, don't be forced to read it. If you read it on another standpoint, then that's fine. So you don't have to read it because I'm telling you to read it. That's just the way the books are set up. So, but with that said, I love you. I appreciate you. Thanks for watching. Hope you enjoyed it. Keep on keeping on and trust in God, and He'll keep you safe and all you say and do. And until later, peace out, everybody. Goodbye. God bless. Have a wonderful rest of your Lord's Day Sunday afternoon, and come back tonight for your weekend series number 2 of Are You Ready for a New Year? New Year's Revolution. And we'll see what that's all about coming up tonight. So until then, goodbye.